Indexers allows us to treat an object like an array. They're declared in the same way as properties, except that we use the this keyword instead of a name, and their accessors take parameters. In this case, the indexer will correspond to an object array called data, so the type of the indexer is set to object. We'll make the getAccessor return the specified element from the object array, and the setAccessor will insert the value into the selected element. With this indexer now in place, we can use our instance of this class as an array, both to get and set elements. The parameter list of an indexer is similar to that of a method, except that it must have at least one parameter, and we can't use the ref or out modifiers. If we need to, we can pass more than one parameter. For example, if we instead had a two-dimensional array, we would need to specify the column as well as the row. The index value does not have to be an integer. We can just as well pass an object as an index, and then have the getAccessor return the index position where that object is located. We can of course provide both of these functionalities by overloading the indexer. It is then the type and number of parameters that determines which indexer gets called. Keep in mind that in a real program, we should always provide range checks in the accessors, so we can avoid exceptions caused by trying to go beyond the length of the array.